One of the major trends of which we find in today's world is that of influencers. Why? Well, many people today are in desperate need of someone to relate to, someone they can be entertained by with what they call motivation, inspiration, and so on. We find many sisters, sadly, becoming more tangled and addicted with social media, to the extent of falling into many ideological and behavioral errors. With the new trend of influencers and social media bloggers are starting to favor the removal of hijab and may even lead to atheism, which poses many questions. 1. Did they follow Islamic teachings? 2. Did they favor this world more than the hereafter? 3. Are they victims of the false promises that life may seem to offer? 4. What do they get in return? And finally, 5. How can we call our sisters and guide them before more fall prey? Brothers and sisters, what is the ruling of hijab? The Quran instructs both Muslim men and women to dress in a modest manner. But there is a disagreement on how these instructions should be interpreted. The verses relating to dress uses the terms khimar, as in head cover, and jilbab, a dress or cloak, rather than hijab. One of more than 6,000 verses in the Quran, about half a dozen refer specifically to the way a woman should dress or walk in public. The clearest verse on the requirement of modest dress is in Surah 24, verse number 31, telling women to guard their private parts and draw the khimar over their bosoms, and say to the believing woman that they should lower their gaze and guard their private parts, that they should not display their beauty and ornaments except what must ordinarily appear thereof, that they should draw their khimar over their breasts and not display their beauty except to their husbands, their fathers, their husbands' fathers, their sons, their husbands' sons, their brothers, or their brothers' sons, or their sisters' sons, or their women, or the slaves whom their right hands possess, or male servants free of physical needs, or small children who have no sense of the shame of sex, and that they should not strike their feet in order to draw attention to their hidden ornaments. Now in Surah 33, verse number 59, Allah says that Muhammad is commanded to ask his family members and other Muslim women to wear outer garments when they go out, so that they are not harassed. O Prophet, enjoin your wives, your daughters, and the wives of true believers that they should cast their outer garments over their persons when abroad. That is most convenient, that they may be distinguished and not be harassed. Imagine your daughter, who is known for her innocence and decency, who has now become rapidly twisted and very imitative of others. And of all people that she would imitate, she follows the path of demented ideologies and attire of which displeases Allah. We need to understand the following. 1. We do not judge those around us. 2. But we should not allow anything that contradicts the teachings of Allah to ever become a part of our family's activities and thoughts. May Allah protect us.